Welcome, boys and girls. I am Pastor Amy, and we are so glad to have you join with us today. I know many of you have gone back to school already, and it might be different having to do school online. But I know with God's help, you're going to be able to do your best. We have been learning about the Psalms in the past several weeks. Do you remember why Psalms are so important to us today, even though they were written so many years ago? The book of Psalms helps us to glimpse or to look at the character of God. It also shows us how we should respond to Him in worship and how we should respond as we go through different situations in our lives. Today, we are going to look at Psalm chapter 8, which reminds us that God is the Creator and about His majestic rule over all. Let's read Psalm 8 right now from the NIV version. Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. You have set your glory in the heavens. Through the praise of children and infants, you have established a stronghold against your enemies to silence the foe and the avenger. When I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars, which you have set in place, what is mankind that you are mindful of them? Human beings that you care for them? You have made them a little lower than the angels and crowned them with glory and honor. You made them rulers over the works of your hands. You put everything under their feet, all flocks and herds and the animals of the wild, the birds in the sky and the fish in the sea, all that swim in the paths of the seas. Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. Let's pray. Father God, thank you for each one who is joining us today. Lord, I pray that you would open our hearts for worship and your word. Speak to us today as we learn more about you and help us to apply the lesson that we will learn to our lives. I pray that you would be with anyone who is sick and not feeling well. Heal their body, dear Lord. Bring peace and comfort to those who are feeling down and need a special touch from you. Thank you that you hear our prayers. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, are you ready to worship? Let's stand up and praise the Lord as we sing.
Glory, honor, and praise. heavens are your tabernacle. Glory to the Lord on high.
God of wonders beyond our galaxy, you are holy, holy. The universe declares your majesty. You are holy, holy.
Lord of heaven and earth.
Hey kids, it's time for
Memory Verse. Memory Verse.
Today's memory verse is Psalm 8:9. Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. Now you try.
As we read in Psalm chapter 8 earlier, we see that it reflects God's creation and that the work of God reflects His majesty. Did you notice that both the first verse and the last verse of Psalm chapter 8 tells us, Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. Today's Bible story is about creation. Does anyone remember where the story of creation is found? It's found in Genesis chapter 1. Genesis is the first book of the Bible as well as the first book of the Old Testament. Join along as we listen to today's story. In the very beginning, there was nothing. Can you imagine looking around and seeing nothing? Do you see anything on the screen right now? It's all black, representing nothing. Can you imagine listening really hard, but hearing nothing? Nothing except God for God? Genesis 1:1 tells us that in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. And God spoke. Let there be light, God said, and all of the sudden light appeared. God separated the light and the darkness, and the first day was created. There was day and there was night. On the second day, God spoke and the water separated from the sky. Up above was the sky and down below was the water. On the third day, God gathered the water to come together so that dry land would appear. God saw what He had created was good. Then God brought about plants, which includes trees, grass, flowers, shrubs, and vines. Wow, that's a lot of different kinds of vegetation, isn't it? On the fourth day, God created the sun to rule the day and the moon to rule the night. God also set the stars in the sky. Was God done yet? No, He still had more to create. He wanted creatures to fly through the sky. What are those? Yes, birds. All kinds of eagles, owls, sparrows, hummingbirds, pelicans, bluebirds, falcons, and every other kind of bird. And God also created creatures to swim the deepest ocean. On day 5, God created the birds of the air and the fish of the sea, and it was good. Then came day 6. This was the day that animals were made. He created all kinds of tame animals, wild animals, and reptiles. Now the land was full of animals of all sizes and shapes, elephants to caterpillars, gorillas to inchworms. It was good. Not only did God create animals, but He also created His most precious creation of all, people. People are so important to God that He created us in His very image. God blessed the people and told them to be fruitful and to rule over all the other creatures. God had formed man from the dust of the earth, but it was God's breath that brought people to life. Isn't that so neat? He is the one who breathed life into man. God saw everything He had created, and He said that it was good. How many days do we have thus far? God created all of that in just 6 days. Amazing, isn't it? Now we read in Genesis chapter 2, verses 1 to 3 from the NIV. Thus the heavens and the earth were completed in all their vast array. By the seventh day, God had finished the work He had been doing. So on the seventh day, He rested from all His work. Then God blessed the seventh day and made it holy, because on it He rested from all the work of creating what He had done. Now let's review the days of creation we just learned. Do you remember what happened on day 1? God created day and night. What happened on day 2? God created the sky and water. What happened on day three? God created the dry land and plants. What happened on day four? God created the sun, moon, and stars. What happened on day five? God created the birds and fish. What happened on day six? God created the land animals and people. What happened on day seven? God rested. Isn't it amazing to learn about how God created our world in just 6 days? And on the seventh day, God rested. Why do you think that God rested on the seventh day? God gave us an example of how we should rest one day a week from our work and use that day to worship God, our Creator. God is a wonderful God, and it is only He who created the world. We should be amazed that our wonderful God knows us and loves us. We worship God because of how wonderful, majestic, and amazing He is. Let's pray. Dear Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. Thank you for creating the world and everything in it. Thank you for creating the animals, plants, and the sea. But most importantly, we thank you for creating each one of us. Lord, thank you for the time we have together today to learn more about you. Help us to know you more, to love you more. Be with us today and this week. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, let's review the days of the creation with this fun song.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. On day number one, God made light. He made the day and He made the night. On day number two, God made the sky. It's big and blue and way up high. Whoa, whoa. On day number three, God made the sea. He made the land, every plant and tree. On day number four, God made the stars. He put the sun in the sky, super duper far. Whoa, whoa. God made you and God made me. He made everyone and everything we see. He made the earth and He made the heavens. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. On day number five, God made birds and fish, dolphins and whales and things that go squish. On day number six, God made animals and bugs, foxes and cubs, all for us to hug. Whoa, whoa. On day number six, God also made man. He said it was good and part of His plan. On day number seven, God stopped to rest. He saw what He made. It was His best. Whoa, whoa. God made you and God made me. He made everyone and everything we see. He made the earth and He made the heavens. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. God made you and God made me. He made everyone and everything we see. He made the earth and He made the heavens. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to Craft Time with Katie. Today we are going to be making a God-created mobile. For today's craft, we are going to be needing a cardstock or a paper plate, white copy paper or another piece of cardstock, a child's drinking cup, a black marker, scissors, colored pencils or markers, paint if you are going to be using your paper plate, pencil, and you're going to be needing a hole puncher. So let's get on to our craft. So if you are going to be using a paper plate, you are going to cut it in half and paint it. But if you are going to be using your cardstock, you are going to draw your cupcake. And let's see. And once you have done that, you will trace over it with a black marker. And once you have done that, you are going to cut it out with your scissors. And once you have done that, you are going to draw God, a G, in any form, or actually, if you are going to be using your paper plate, make sure you also draw God created on it. So I'm going to draw my God created. Let's see. You can draw, do whatever design you want for your lettering, but for your O, you are going to try to draw a world that God created. Okay. Once you've done your God, put created on the bottom. Okay, then you can color it whatever color you want. Do great for the world. Let's see, what color am I going to do? Thank you. So you should keep going and keep coloring until you've gotten all the letters filled out. Okay. So once you have done that, you are going to use your hole puncher and hole punch 7 holes in your paper to represent the 7 days of creation on your the bottom. 1, 2, 3. Make sure they're about 1 inch apart. Okay, then you're going to do 1 more at the top so that you can hang the top in your mobile. And you're also going to do your paper plate too. Remember to do it on your paper plate. And now let's go on to your 6 days of creation. 7. So what you're going to do is trace your cup onto your page and do it 3 times on the top and 3 times on the bottom, and then you should have 1 in the middle and it should look like this. And once you are done doing that, you are going to trace over it with your black marker and it should look like this. So then you are going to cut 1 of them out, all of them out. Hole punch the top, and you should do it with all of them, and then they will end up looking like this. So for your days of creation, for the first day, God created light and day. So for your card, that is light and night. So for your thing, your card, you are going to color 1 side of them black to represent night. And then leave the other one blank to represent the day within which is the light. Right, we have day 1 done. Now for day 2, you are going to draw a squiggly line in the middle of your card. And then you are going to color the bottom half a dark blue to represent the water that God has created. Let's review. What did God create on the 2nd day? Water and sky. I forgot to mention, make sure if you want, you can draw 2 or 3 clouds, maybe small ones, so that that will represent the sky. Now for your sky, you're going to color it a lighter blue than the water. Alright, now that is done. So now we are going to move on to day 3. God created on day three land and plants. So you can draw your tree, and then you will draw land, and then you can either draw or put a sticker if you have any of a flower. Draw a flower or put a sticker. So you are going to draw your flower, like I said. And then you are going to color the ground brown to represent it. Okay, no. So you will proceed to color or put your sticker on for your flower, and then color your tree. So this should be your finished product. And then let's move on to day four. For day four, you are going to use your cup and make a crescent moon. That. Trace. And done. You will also be wanting to do a star or three stars. Okay. And now let's do the sun. The sun will be your bigger part of the circle. Next, I colored my stars. And if you have stickers that are shaped like stars, you can use them. Next is day five. So on day five, God created fish and birds. Draw some birds on the top of your circle, and then draw some fish on the bottom of your circle. And then you will color them any color you want. So I have finished coloring mine, and if you have stickers that are shaped like fish, you can use those too. What did God create on day five? Fish and birds. Now let's move on to day six. Day six, God created animals and man. So you can draw a man and a woman. Okay, and then you can put a slash through your center of your circle and then draw an animal. You can try to draw a horse. All right. So since you now color, you can color it now. So what did God create on the fifth day? Sixth day, God created man and animals. So the people that are represented in this picture are Adam and Eve, with which God created on the sixth day. What happened on the seventh day of creation? What did God do? He rested. So we are going to put God rested on the seventh circle. And then color it. So this is the finished product of God rested. Now it's time to put your yarn into use. So for your yarn, you are going to loop a piece of yarn through your hole. So your yarn should be about 9 inches for the four pieces of yarn. And then for the smaller pieces of yarn, it should be about 7 inches. If you want it to look like ours. So you might need help tying these. So you might get an older sibling or a parent to help you tie them. So we are going to keep rotating your yarn from small to large. And you we'll see the finished product. So now we have one piece of yarn left over from all your strung yarn. You are going to put this yarn at the top of your mobile. For this one, you are going to make a loop and it will look like this. Now it's time to string on your days of creation. So you are going to start from the first day, which is day and night. Now we are going to put on the second day, within which is sky and water. And now you are going to put on your day three, within which is land and plants. And now you are going to do your day four, within which is sun, moon, and stars. And now you are going to be doing your day five, within which is fish and birds. And now you are going to do day six, within which is the people and the animals. And now you are going to do the last one, day seven, within which is God rested. This is the finished craft. I hope you have fun doing it.
Thank you for joining us with Craft Time with Katie today. We look forward to seeing you next week. Have an awesome day. Bye.
Bye.